got sold again to the guys at Harris Drennan and Larry Redder. And my dad drove this car in 67, 68, 69 at Fairbury, Lincoln, Danville, all the small tracks around here. And he restored this, and Gunner and Dad restored this car in 96. And I'm the lucky guy that gets to take it and listen to stories and have a great time taking it out and showing it off a little bit.
Well, I tell you what, it is a beautiful piece. And again, anytime the Vintage Racing Series comes along, it's good to get up close and personal to some of these beautiful machines. We thank you for bringing it out here, and it's awesome. And continue to support, and we love seeing you guys out here.
Thank you. I'm having a ball. I appreciate it.
Well, there you go. Give Greg Riblett a nice round of applause. He's in the Marlon Riblett tribute car. Remember the... in the 89 Jack Tyne car, Roger Duncan here with us. Roger, I tell you what, this beautiful 89 has put many a laps on these bull rings here in Illinois. This absolutely gorgeous. Thank you for bringing it out here. Can you tell us a little bit about it, maybe?
I know it was built in the winter of 79. It won the championship in Fairbury, 81 and 83. It was the first car to have rack and pinion steering in the Midwest. That's about all I know.
So I tell you what, a lot of great history, and I know Jack Tyne, I know Steve Tyne as well. The Tyne family was very successful throughout the Midwest, and of course in northern Illinois, central Illinois, I know Fairbury as well, I'm sure down here at Farmer City. So we appreciate you bringing this beautiful ride down here for us, and have some fun tonight on this big extravaganza, so thanks.
Okay, thanks to the fans too.
There you go. Give him a round of applause. Of the 44 1965 Fairbury track champion, Lynn Wilson. His son, 00 Dennis Wilson. Dennis, how about a nice round of applause, race fans? Dennis, thanks for being here. A beautiful looking ride. And I know you're excited to be a part of this.
Yeah, unfortunately, due to my dad's health, he couldn't be here. So they made me drive it in his place. It's a tribute car that my Uncle Bill and Doug Morris put together of a 1966 car that my Uncle Bill and my dad had. They had a lot of success together in those years, and I just wish my dad could be here.
Well, I tell you what, it's a beautiful looking ride. Well, you'll probably tell us a little bit about Route 66. I tell you what, Joe's Garage, Joe's got a beautiful looking place, doesn't he?
Yeah, it's an awesome place. If you haven't been there, try to visit it. They've got a good website that tells you all about it. There's a lot of great memories there.
I tell you what, in Towanda, Illinois, in Route 66, you can see this car, the pictures, the history. Thank you very much, Mr. Wilson. And this Lynn Wilson tribute car is absolutely beautiful. We hope, wish the best of health for your father, and thanks for being here, Dennis.
Thank you.
There you go. Give Dennis a nice round of applause. The one driver that I actually know, and the driver that needs no introductions, the owner, the driver, and the original car. How about it for the green weenie, Sammy Ding Ding Lee? Fantastic. We're stretching it, Sammy. I tell you what, this beautiful looking ride, the original, you said Roger. Our Bill Crickhouse, the owner there. Sammy, it's always good to see you. Always great to see your smiling face. And these fans, just like myself, love to see the green weenie.
Well, thank you.
You got any history or any stories you could share with us before you set off here tonight? Any memories here at the Farmer City Raceway?
Well, I was telling the gal out there, one of the memories I had was one time I was down here and I caught on fire and tried to pull into the infield and clipped one of the promoters. I don't remember if it was Lonnie Franklin or Bill McLaughlin, but one of them was in there. I was trying to get the fire extinguisher, and one of them.
I tell you what, this green weenie's been an awful awesome sight, and it's good to see it back out here in the quarter mile. You have some fun tonight with it, okay?
Okay.
There you go. How about a nice round of applause to Green Weenie, Sammy Lee, all part of our drivers here tonight. As they head around the Speedway, race fans, we're going to recognize some other drivers that are here tonight as well. And if you're here, stand up. Some of our former drivers drove car number 4. His hometown is Macon, Illinois. And he remembers racing with all the great guys. Jim Ader. Jim, where are you at? Stand up. Also, the driver of car number 52, he hailed out of Decatur, Illinois. One of his Farmer City memories was racing on the top of the judges stand, winning championships. How about it for Roger Drake? Driver out of Saybrook, Illinois. I know he got a big feature win at the Fairbury American Legion Speedway. I'm sure he got one here at Farmer City as well. How about it for number 27, Gary In. Thank you so much, Gary. We got an American Picker star. He hails out of Gibson City, Illinois. Drove car number 8. He said his favorite Farmer City memory was back in 1962. How about a nice round of applause for Beetle Leisure? Where's Beetle at? All right, Beetle. Thank you very much. Driver of the car number 28, his hometown is Sullivan, Illinois. He won quite a few here at Farmer City. How about it for Pickle Standifer? All right, Pickle. And the familiar car number 95, he hails out of Bloomington, Illinois. He's here each and every Friday night. Some of his Farmer City memories are he's hit the flag stand. Unfortunately, he shattered his knees, got season championship, and he's raced again his kids and his grandkids. How about it for the veteran, Frank Schickel Sr.? The 62, that is Justin Rutledge, and the 05 is Matt Raymer. So it looks like a complete inversion. We're going to go green next time by as they put some of the fastest cars in the back. And we'll see if we have ourselves a race here. Matt Raymer in 05 is awful fast in that heat race, as well as Rutledge in the 62. Justin Rutledge in 62. Here we go. I'm not sure how many laps it is, but we're going to have some fun with the Vintage Racing Series here at the DeWitt County Fairgrounds. Lightning McQueen in 95 and Keith Lucas in 44. Here we go. We're officially underway. Oop, the Hudson Hornet. Off the speedway, and we're going to stay green. Good news. Down the back straightaway we go. They're 3 and 4 wide throughout. Down the front straightaway. Leader lap number 1 is the 44 car of Keith Lucas. Lucas showing the way. Lightning McQueen second. Oh, we got a car spinning in 621. That is Ryan Wilson. And Ryan Wilson will bring it. Oh, and a big spin down the back straightaway. John Powell, the 21, I believe that is Brendan Raymer. Raymer third. Fourth is the 12 of Robert Mitchell. We'll talk to your winner down in victory lane as the 44, Keith Lucas, shows the way. We're back underway. Beautiful sight here at the DeWitt County Fairgrounds. The Vintage Racing Series of Illinois gets a refire. Problems for the 62 of Rutledge down the back straightaway. Keep your eyes on that 42. Boy, he knows how to get through here. The 42 on the move. Meanwhile, the battle for that 4 spot. Oh, they're 4 wide. Here comes the 05. He started dead last. Matt Raymer out of Minota, Illinois. Going after the 12 of Robert Mitchell down the back straightaway. Looking to go 3 wide. Matt Raymer on the move in 05. They're 3 wide. What action here? Oh, hold on to him, boys. Hold on. And, oh, big wreck here in the front stretch. So far, there's, oh, my gosh. They crashed 8 times, but we stay green. Car, oh, and the caution comes out. Caution out. Debris. in four. Well, the 0-5 of Matt Raymer, the man on the move. He started dead last, 12-05. So Robert Mitchell in front of the 0-5. Green flags back out. We're back underway. Keep your eyes on the 0-5 of Matt Raymer to the outside of the 12. Down the back straightaway, here comes Lightning McQueen for the race lead. Down the back straightaway, here comes Craig Hughes. Here comes the 0-5 of Matt Raymer. Now we got a couple of cars, bumpers hooked up, and the caution comes out. The caution comes out. Good run for the 28 of Ron Wilson. We're going green. 12 laps remain here in the Vintage Feature. First of five exciting features here tonight. We're back underway. There comes the 95, looking to pull the trigger down the back straightaway. Can't get the job done. Here comes the 12 and the 5 now. Matt Raymer and the 12 of Robert Mitchell. Matt Raymer way upstairs on the top shelf down the front straightaway. They're three wide. Give it to Raymer. Matt Raymer showing the way, dusting off the top shelf here at the DeWitt County Fairgrounds. Down the back straightaway, here comes the 44, trying to hold on for a second. That's Keith Lucas, gaggle of them behind him. Here comes the 58 of Randy Lucas and the 12 of Robert Mitchell now. Side by side for that fifth spot. 95 of Lightning McQueen down to the inside, going to take second. So McQueen not a second. Here comes 58 of Randy Lucas on that high side, looking to go three wide for third with the 12 of Robert Mitchell and the 44 of Keith Lucas. Good action for that third spot, three wide. Looking to make it four wide is Ron Wilson. They'll three wide down the back straightaway. And they'll split the 44 Lucas. Here comes Ron Wilson now. Here comes the 12 of Robert Mitchell. We're still green. Laps continue to wind down. Matt Raymer way out in front here tonight. Craig Hughes and that Lightning McQueen car, big piece of debris here on the front straightaway. Looks like we're going to stay green. Now the caution comes out, doggone it. Caution out, big piece of debris. 5, Matt Raymer continues to show the way. 95 of Craig Hughes second. Here comes the 58 of Randy Lucas. Randy Lucas to the outside of Lightning McQueen here on the restart. Here the Vintage Racing Series. They start to fan out just a bit. And boy, the class of the field here tonight is Matt Raymer, the young man out of Mendota, Illinois, continues to lead. They'll stack him up two by two, by two, by two behind your race leader. As the 58 going to go to third now, or second now, that's Randy Lucas. So Lucas now to second, McQueen back to third. Here comes the fourth, 12 of Robert Mitchell to the outside or to the inside. I believe that's Ron Wilson at 28. As we got a car spinning, caution out once again. Number 62, Justin Rutledge has come to a stop in the 68 Mustang. Caution out. Green's out, back underway. Zero 5 of Matt Raymer continues to show the way. Second is the 58. He's on the move now. That's Randy Lucas. Lucas in the 58 has found a stride right in the middle of the speedway. Now in the back straight, where comes Randy Lucas now? 95 of Lightning McQueen, better known as Craig Hughes, continues to hold down third, but the battle for the race lead is a good one. Here comes the 58 of Randy Lucas. 0-5 of Matt Raymer continues to show the way. Lucas right through the middle of the speedway. Lightning McQueen third, Ron Wilson up to fourth. Ooh, some contact there in the fifth spot. That's the 12 of Robert Mitchell in the 621. Of Raymer, and Raymer again will initiate contact. Or excuse me, Ryan Wilson will stay green. 62 of Rutledge off the speedway. Justin Rutledge calls it a night. We'll stay green. Laps wind down. Matt Raymer looking for the white flag next time by. Two to go, I apologize. Two to go. 58 of Randy Lucas, second. Lightning McQueen, third. Ron Wilson, fourth. 12 is fifth. That's Robert Mitchell. Final time, ladies and gentlemen. Matt Raymer out of Mendota, Illinois. Continues to show the way. Down the back straightaway. He works into three. And off of four out of Mendota, Illinois, in the 68 Chevelle, Matt Raymer wins here tonight at Farmer City. Second to go to the 58 of Randy Lucas. Top aside for third. We'll give it to Lightning McQueen. Fourth, unofficially, is Ron Wilson. There we go, race fans. We'll talk to him as he climbs out. Give him one big round of applause. He pilots a 1968 Chevelle. As he climbs out, put your hands together. Let's hear it for the 05. Bob Kelly. And 5 climbs out. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner here tonight, Matt Raymer. Well, I tell you what, Matt, you were so fast they started you in the back. I tell you what, they couldn't hold you back, my friend. You were working that high side. That was fun to watch. Fun to watch this 68 Chevelle go to the front. Good job.
Thank you so much. Thank you all to the fans tonight for coming out. With the weather last night, sure didn't know what we were going to get for tonight, that's for sure. But love coming here to Farmer City. We try to get down here as much as possible with our street stock and our crate car. But had a new baby a couple or 2 months ago, so we've been a little bit busy with that stuff. But thank you, Farmer City, for help having us here tonight. It was a tough battle out there coming from the back. The heat race. We missed the setup a little bit in the heat race and didn't have a lot of time to prepare for the feature. I wanted to change the gear, and we didn't even get to that. So we just pretty much put some gas in it, change the tire, and come back out. So
I tell you what, an inch of rain this morning here at the DeWitt County Fairgrounds. The track crew worked awful hard, put on a good racing service, slick top to bottom, and they did a fine job. Congratulations, my friend, winning the big feature here tonight.
Thank you so much. Thank you again, fans, for coming out tonight. We appreciate you guys. We'll be at Fairbury next Saturday night if you guys want to come out and see us. We usually try, and a lot of people think that we go out and draw straws to see who wins and stuff like that. But as you can see out here, we bump, bang, push, do a little bit. You know, we try to put on a show for you guys. So thank you so much for coming out, and thank you, Farmer City Raceway.
We did a fine job here tonight. Matt Raymer, your big winner, the Vintage Racing of Illinois. Raymer gets the job done.